In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit.
And with your spirit.
How are you all? Bonjour. Sorry. Comment ça va?
So far.
I sincerely thank you for coming for the Mass. It was a short notice, but you are willing to come. Thank you so much for joining us for this Mass today. Let us prepare our hearts and minds that we may worthily participate in this Holy Mass and receive the Eucharist. Lord Jesus, you came to forgive our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to heal our wounds. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to bring salvation to this whole world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpassed the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from Galatians. Brothers and sisters, realize that it is those who have faith who are children of Abraham. Scripture, which saw in advance that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, foretold the good news to Abraham, saying, "Through you shall all the nations be blessed." Consequently, those who have faith are blessed along with Abraham, who had faith. For all who depend on works of the law are under a curse. For it is written, "Cursed be everyone who does not persevere in doing all the things written in the book of the law." And that no one is justified before God by the law is clear, for the one who is righteous by faith will live. But the law does not depend on faith. Rather, the one who does these things will live by them. Christ ransomed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, "Cursed be everyone who hangs on a tree," that the blessing of Abraham might be extended to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Our responsorial song. The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights. The Lord will ransom his covenant forever. Majesty and glory are his work, and his justice endures forever. He has won renown for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant. He has made known to his people the power of his works, giving them the inheritance of the nations. The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is my beloved son. Listen to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus had driven out a demon, some of the crowd said, "By the power of Beelzebul, the prince of demons, he drives out demons." Others, to test him, asked him for a sign from heaven. But he knew their thoughts and said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself will be laid waste, and house will fall against house. And if Satan is divided against himself, how will his kingdom stand? For you say that it is by Beelzebul that I drive out demons. If I then drive out demons by Beelzebul, by whom do your own people drive them out? Therefore, they will be your judges. But if it is by the finger of God that I drive out demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. When a strong man fully armed guards his palace, his possessions are safe. But when one stronger than he attacks and overcomes him, he takes away the armor on which he relied and distributes the spoils. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. When an unclean spirit goes out of someone, it roams through arid regions, searching for rest, but finding none, it says, 'I shall return to my home from which I came.' But upon returning, it finds it swept clean and put in order. Then it goes and brings back seven other spirits, more wicked than itself, who move in and dwell there. And the last condition of that man is worse than the first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the Gospel flow with you. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, a kingdom divided against itself will fall. A home divided against itself will fall. A family is divided against itself will fall. A nation divided against itself will fall. Therefore, it is important that we are united in our thoughts, in our mind, in our actions. The more we are divided, it is easy for the enemy to attack us. That is why Jesus wants us to stay together, be strong, to stay together with Christ. When we are staying together, a powerful person, no enemy can attack us. Therefore, Christ is our strength. Christ is our Savior. So we are to stand close with Him so that no enemy can attack. Do you know what divides a family or a country or a nation? It is false accusations. You know, people, when they pass false judgments and a false accusation against each other, it is very easy for them to be divided. Therefore, we must stop judging one another. We must stop passing false judgment on each other. Rather, we are to see the goodness in each other, appreciate and keep up the good spirit that we have in each other. And that is how we can stand together as a community and believers of Christ. Let us pray for ourselves. Let us pray for our families, pray for our nation, that we may not pass false accusation, judge one another, rather we stand together and stay strong together with Christ. Amen. Let us offer before God all our prayers and intentions. God, our loving Father, we pray for our Pope Francis, our Bishop Robert Daly, our Pastor Father Jim Plourde, all the priests, deacons, lay ministers, that we may always help the people to stay together. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all the people, all the residents here at the Border View Nursing Home and Rehabilitation Center. Bless all the residents, all the volunteers, all the staff, all the doctors, nurses, all the visitors who come here. May we find a home of peace here. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. Lord, we pray for all the people who asked our prayers. Lord, kindly grant them their daily needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the people who are deceased in our family and in our community. Especially we pray for Ronald and Herman Sear, Ellen Gendro, for whom we offer this Mass today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our loving Father, we thank you for all the many blessings you have given us in our lives. Lord, give us the wisdom and understanding that we may not pass false judgment on one another and make judgments on one another. Rather, may we always come together in Christ and stand together strong. For this and for all the prayers that we have today, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By this mysteries of mingling of water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. And may your sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, O Lord. God, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Father most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent us our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and was willingly entered into his passion, he took the bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all the people who are participating in this Mass today. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. In a special way, we remember and pray for Ronald and Herman Sear, Eldon Jandro, for whom we offer this Mass today. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Pope John Paul II, St. Teresa of Calcutta, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Prohemon widohemon in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Together let us pray to the Father in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are with us forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself only to you. never permit to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
My sincere thanks for you today, for being our lector today. Thank you so much. And I'd like to thank you all for participating in this Mass today. May God bless you all and have a wonderful week.
Thank you, Father.
God bless you.